It's Miss Belinda. I am sitting here in the pre-K to K classroom at St. Thomas Episcopal Church in Newark, Delaware. Thank you so much for joining me for our Sunday School lesson for the seventh Sunday of Easter. Let's get started. We'll light our Paschal candle. The Lord be with you, and also with you. We gather in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So, as I said, it is the seventh Sunday of Easter this week. Remember that Easter is the time that we celebrate that Jesus died, but God made him alive again. So we are going to continue our story about Jesus and his friends after Jesus was resurrected. Let's see, we're getting ready for me. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Remember when we sing that song, we know it's time to get ready. Our eyes should be watching, our ears should be listening, our hands and feet are tucked. I have this box today that has our story. Right. I think it's a resurrection box. Because it's white. And it has this cross on it. Can you see that? I don't know if you can see. There it is. The box is white. And the cloth that we tell our story on today is white. I wonder why everything is white. I wonder why it's called a resurrection box. There are some things inside, so maybe the things inside will show us why it's a resurrection box. Let's open it and find out. Okay. Okay. Lots of things in this box. I bet this is going to show us why it's a resurrection box. For sure. Hmm. I think I'm starting to see. Mm-hmm. Boys and girls, I can tell. I think I know why. It's called a resurrection box. I left all the things. That was a lot of things. Okay. I think we're ready to start. This is a tomb. It's a place to put a dead person. Jesus died and was buried in a tomb. This was the Jesus who said and did such wonderful things. Jesus died, but God made him alive again. Some of Jesus' friends had seen an angel who told them that Jesus was alive. Others ran and found the tomb empty. One of the women had seen Jesus. He called her by name, and she knew the sound of his voice. Many of Jesus' friends wondered what had really happened. This is a road to a city called Emmaus. On the same day that Mary saw Jesus, on the same day that Peter and John ran to the empty tomb to see what had happened, on that same day, two of Jesus' friends had walked on that road to Emmaus. Another person joined them, but the friend did not know who he was. Then he took the bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to them. And then the friend knew it was Jesus. Jesus was alive. Then Jesus went away. The two friends hurried back to Jerusalem to tell Jesus' other friends what had happened. On that same day, Jesus' friends gathered in the upper room. As they talked, suddenly Jesus was with them. He showed them his hands and his side. He asked for something to eat. He talked with disciples, and then suddenly, Jesus went away. The next Sunday, Thomas was with the friends. Suddenly, Jesus came. He said, "Peace be with you." Thomas believed when he saw Jesus. He did not need to touch him. And again, Jesus left suddenly. Jesus' friends must have spent time talking about all that had happened, about the amazing things Jesus said and the wonderful things that he did. One day, Peter said, "I'm going fishing." James, John, Thomas, and three other friends said, "We'll go with you." Jesus fixed breakfast for seven of his friends. They ate fish and bread with him one morning after they had fished all night. One more time, Jesus would appear to his friends. Jesus told his friends to stay in Jerusalem and to wait there for a special gift that God would send them, the Holy Spirit. This special gift would give them power to be able to tell others about Jesus and the amazing things that he did and said. While Jesus talked, he lifted his hands to bless them. And as he lifted his hands, he was taken up into heaven. A cloud hid Jesus, and he was gone. As the friends looked up into the sky, two angels stood beside them. The angels told them that Jesus was gone to heaven. Someday, he would come back again. I wonder what part of the story you like best. I wonder what part of the story is the most important. I wonder who you are in the story. I wonder if there's any part that we could take away and still have all that we need. Hi, boys and girls. This would be the time that we have our response usually, but you're at home and I'm here. So I wanted to tell you about an art response topic that I'm working on for next week, Pentecost. Remember that Pentecost is that time that the church celebrates the church's birthday. And here at St. Thomas's, we all wear red. We have orange and yellow and red streamers. So I sent you a project in your email, in your mom and dad's email, that you can work on. There's a wing top to work on, and there are streamers to work on that I'd love to have you guys make and bring back next week so that we can all see them. Okay? And I'll bring mine. Right. And I'm sure there are other cool things that you and your family can work on to get ready for Pentecost and respond to the story we just did. So I can't wait to see what you and your family do. Alright guys, let's pray. Let's say the children's creed first. I believe in God above. I believe in Jesus' love. I believe His Spirit too comes to show us what to do. I believe that I can be kind and loving, Lord, like Thee. All right, let's say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now it's time for our own personal prayer. Remember, that's the time that we can pray for whatever we want, whatever we need, whatever we need to say to God. We can do that. We can say the things that we're thankful for, things that someone else might need, things we're worried about. Okay, I'll start. And then I want you to tell someone what you'd like to pray for today. Okay, let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the coming of spring. We thank you for giving us the things that we need. Good food, a house to live in, family and friends. We thank you for sending the Holy Spirit to us to always be with us, to comfort us when we're afraid. We thank you for sending our parents to take care of us, and our grandparents, and our families. I thank you especially for my children. I thank you for the children of St. Thomas's and their families. I thank you for all the friends that lead worship ministry with me. I'm so grateful for them. I pray for all the people who are sick, all the people who don't have permit homes. I pray for the children who don't have enough food to eat. I pray, Lord, that you help me to find ways to help others as a way to serve you in the world. Amen. All right. You tell someone else what you'd like to pray for today. Amen. All right. Time to put out. I'm sorry. It's time to change the light. So here in our classroom, we know that the light does not go out. We know that this light of Christ changes. And that this light can move around the room and through our church building and through our community to surround us with God's love. Let's sing our blessing song. We can say goodbye. Go now in peace. Go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere you may go.